Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Basic of ServiceNow Learning. So in this today video we will explore ACL, means we will take a little overview on ACL with a practical example. So before starting with this ACL, let's prepare some data so it will be a little helpful for us to understand what ACL is and how we will configure ACL for a particular record or a field. Let's see. So first we will create a role in ServiceNow application. You see, navigate to roles and we will create a new role over here. Let's get like a new ACL. This is a new role which we are creating. Okay, so new ACL role. So we have created a role that the name of the role is new ACL. Now we assign this role or provide this role to a user. Let us navigate to a user table. So we have lots of users over here. Let's select this user, SR assignment user, means assignment first user. So I'm giving this role to this user, clicking on edit, and the role name is new ACL. Okay, so to prepare a data, what we have done, we have created a role, new role, and give that new role to a user. The username is as assignment first user, or we can say SR underscore assignment user is his ID. Now let's have an overview on ACL. Now, so in this filter navigator we type ACL. See, in system security we have an option called ACL control. Okay, so I am clicking on this. We have an access control list. We have a lots of names, operations, types, active, etc. and etc. See, we don't have any option to create an access control even though we have logged in through an admin user. So what to do then? The question is that for creating an ACL we need a specific role. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to elevate role. When we click on elevate role, it displayed to us security underscore admin role. So friend, please make sure always that when we have to create an ACL or when we have to modify the ACL, a user should have a security underscore admin role, then only he can work on ACL. So what I am going, I am checking the checkbox, clicking on OK. And now we have a new button in access control list. So that it means that we can create a new ACL or we can create a new access control. So for creating an ACL, a person has to take a elevated role. That is kind of a like a privileged role. It means the user having a role for a some time, not for always. Means again he has to take a same role to work on an ACL. So let's click on new now. When I clicked on new, so we have a lots of fields over here: type, operation, admin override, application, active, advanced, name, description, etc. etc. So friend, first we see what ACL is. ACL actually restrict access to data by requiring user to pass a set of requirements before they interact with it. So what is the set of requirement which user has to pass? So the first requirement is the user has one of the roles specified in the role list, means in the role list, the role which we have specified in the role list, the user must have that role to perform the particular activity which we have mentioned in the ACL. The second thing is the conditions in the condition field evaluate to true. It means whatever conditions we are giving in this condition field should evaluate to true, then only a user can access the particular field or can do anything on that field. The last thing is the script in the script field evaluates to true or set the variable answer to true or is empty. It means that script should evaluate to true, or if it is empty then it is okay. Same is for condition. If the given condition is true or the condition should be empty. To see here we don't have a script option available. So when we click on admin, then we have a script section available in the form. So let's see where we implement this access control list. So I'll open an incident form first. In incident form, we have lots of fields. So I will apply ACL on approval name. The functionality should be, if the user has the new role which we have created earlier, then only user can edit the approval name. Otherwise it will be not available for other users to edit it or write into this field. Means for other users, those who don't have that role, that approval name field display as read only, and the user who have that role should work on this particular field. So we achieve this functionality through ACL. Let's see how. So in access control list, we have operation, we have in types, we have like client callable script include processor, record, rest endpoint, UIP. So here we are selecting a record because we are working on a record, we are working on a field. In operation, we are talking about write operation, that a user having a role must write on that field, otherwise not. So I click on write. Admin override, it means admin can do any activity. He does not require a specific role to perform something. He always, when we click on admin override, it means admin can perform anything. Then active, then advance, name, it means we have to select the table where we have to perform this functionality or where we have to apply the ACL. And then none field, this is the another field where we have to select the field. So the field name is approver name. So this is basically a configuration which we are doing in ACL. Now the role, the person need a role means the role which we have created earlier. The role is new ACL. Here we are not giving a condition, not giving a script, mentioning it as a empty so that it will be evaluated as true, because here we are only taking an overview. Okay, so what I am going to do is now I am saving this. When I am saving this, this ACL has been created. Okay, let's navigate to the ACL. See, we have an incident.u approver name. So friends, please be sure whenever we create any ACL for a table or anything, then table name comes first and the field name comes with the dot. Okay, so this is basically an automatic name or automatically occur through the ServiceNow. So there is no need to give this name. This automatically occurs in the access control list. Just for example, I am typing incident over here. See, when I type incident, it displays whatever the ACL has been applied to access control list. This incident.resolved by, it means that this particular ACL is created for a resolved by field. Or incident.caller ID, it means that this ACL is created for a caller ID field in an incident table. The same as the field which we have created, u_approve_name in an incident table. Okay, so let's test it whether this particular functionality is working as required or not. So what I will do, I will first open with the user who have that role, and then I will open with the user who don't have that role. So I am impersonating a user from here to, let's see, the user which having a role is first user, I believe, assignment first user, this one. Okay, so let's see. I'm navigating to an incident now. Creating new. So when we navigate to the person who having that new role which we have given to him, he able to modify this field. See, now I'll open this incident form from the user who don't have this role. So in another browser, I have that user which don't have this role. I'm refreshing this page. Or I can say reloading this page. Now I'm opening incident. See, this field is read only for the user who don't have that role. So in this way we can apply a ACL. So friend, this is the overview for ACL. I believe you all will understand how we have to work on ACL. when we have to work on ACL, the three condition must met. The first condition is the role. The user must have a specific role to perform that activity. The second condition is condition. So whatever the condition we have given, that condition needs to be true. Otherwise, the condition should be empty. The third condition is script. If the script evolutes to true or the script is empty, then the user can pass a set of requirements to interact with the fields. So friend, this is all for this video. Friends, if you like this video, please do subscribe my channel and please provide your feedback and suggestions in the comment box mentioned below. Thank you friends. Bye bye.